Hi, everybody, and welcome to my new City Skylines series, Gramercy. I'm really excited to get started on this and get working to make sort of something that's really close to where I live, which is Brooklyn, New York. So I'm going to be taking a lot of New York City, a lot of sort of other areas I visit, so there's going to be some San Francisco, some other sorts of things involved here. But for starters, I started on a map from the Steam Workshop by Zacharias, which I really like. I've used it a couple times in the past. But this one, I went and carved out a larger harbor to kind of emulate New York Harbor and kind of provide more of a real reason for the city to be built here. I know a lot of cities are built on rivers and things, especially in Europe, but here New York is really based around the fact that it has one of the best natural harbors in the world. So I just went and quickly carved out a little bit of land inside and started shaping stuff. In that, I needed to replace the ship pads and things, and now I'm just planting a quick highway to the outside. Most of that highway is going to stay kind of roughly, but I start making changes honestly by the end of this episode. So right here I'm carving out our first sort of area to build. It's the Navy Yards. So these are actually very close to where I really live here in Brooklyn. And it's a really neat area just because it's undergoing a lot of change right now. It was actually where they built a lot of big battleships and just kind of any ship previously, but lately they're using the space just because it's nice, there's like decent transit, and there are a lot of areas that nobody are using, which is really rare for New York. So you're starting to see a lot of TV studios, and there's a big greenhouse, there's a lot of artist studios and event spaces and things out there. So I figured it'd be really cool. So for right now, I'm quickly grabbing a bunch of props to try and see if I can build new dry dock, sort of the gates that would close them off. But unfortunately, props compress, they don't like being placed in water, so I end up having to scrap that idea. I'm really shaping and working a lot with the keys and the canals in-game. They don't play nice with each other, so this ended up being a huge chore. I actually get rid of most of the canals later. But some quick warehouses and things, and then I end up downloading and grabbing the seawalls just to provide these gates for the dry docks. I stick some open ones across most ends for the dry docks just because I want them to be full. But of course, one we have to have empty just to show that it's there. So I'm now making something from real life. It's a big pile of, I believe it's the salt that they use on the roads in the winter here, but this is pulled pretty much straight from Google Maps and from my visit there. Just wanted to kind of get a sample of the detail at work that I want to get done. So placing a lot of containers, placing a lot of decals just to kind of get the detail up where I'd like it. Now I'm going to start working on placing cranes. So that's one thing that the Navy Yard absolutely does have, is a lot of shipbuilding cranes and things. Maybe not quite these container cranes, but I really like their size and kind of addition to the skyline. And what's really neat about these cranes is they all run on massive broad gauge train tracks, basically, so that they didn't have to have like 10 cranes at every single dry dock, they could just wheel them around. So that was definitely a detail that I wanted to emulate, so I went and laid out a distance and copy and pasted with Moveit to get the tracks pretty much everywhere I wanted them. So I end up peeling around and making curves, and this actually took a really long time. There's a ton of anarchy here to get them very smooth onto each other and over roads and everything. I didn't want to add two train crossings every time, so they're just clipped over the roads. Now I kind of go outside the surface painted area, really, and start placing roads and things. I use this giant new coal power plant by Avania. That unfortunately doesn't stay, it's just a little too large. Now I really kind of get started on some of the detail work. We do some cool decal stuff in the inside of the empty dry dock to show that it's like rusted and kind of ocean-y with some stains and drains and all sorts of things like that. And now we just kind of work on some of these brownfield sites, which are former industrial areas where the ground's all polluted and really dirty. They haven't necessarily been renovated yet. They might even still be active, but they're just kind of not nice places. Those are really hard to achieve in City Skylines, just because it's really made for a cleaner style. So this entire sort of pier, I go and I use the sand texture just to make it a little more interesting, I guess, and then just absolutely coat it with decals and things to make it really gross looking. Few industrial buildings and props to really kind of bring the fact that this is maybe just straight up abandoned or something. A lot of grass as well. The greenery is really hard in this area because there isn't a ton in real life, especially natural like wild stuff, which is really great in game. So here I'm just decorating a bit of the more modern sort of water treatment facility that I put in here. It's really neat, so I want to give a lot of the infrastructure in the city kind of a newly renovated sort of vibe. So there's a lot of these curb planters, which you're going to get nice, really young trees, just to enhance the idea that this stuff was renovated. Over here I go and stick some water tanks, end up trying to do zonable but go ploppable instead. Just a little bit of parking, and here's where I can cram in some nice trees and everything just to add a little bit of texture that you don't really get with big industrial streetscapes. Quickly going adding a bunch of cars and trucks all around just because people gotta work here. So I add a lot of decals and things just to kind of make the concrete look a little bit more interesting. I'm looking for some small buildings. I end up settling on Beard Monkey's inspection barn from his way station, and I start adding just some more industrial decals and then some hatching just to make sure that nobody drives on this on the crane tracks, basically. I go and add a bunch of decals and things just to break up the concrete texture I'm using. I've actually have a modified version of the one from Strictoes to Sinu project, which is really nice because it's very, very plain, so you don't end up with grid lines that don't match or whatever, but it really makes it so that you have to add a ton of decals and details to make it look less like, I guess, a gray canvas almost. But it's really handy because I can go and set up expansion lines and patches and things anywhere I'd like to. So here I'm just going and adding some more parking. It's pretty much all over this place in real life, and I figure why not stick some in here. It's one of the few places in the city that I'm gonna have a lot of surface parking, just because the rest I really hope to be a little more dense. I'm adding some more details inside these buildings and around. This sort of old factory here I imagine to be like a brewery, which actually exists in the Navy Yard, which is really cool. So I'm going and placing, again, more parking, more kind of truck parking and car parking as well. So I want to have like a private lot for the brewery, and then here I'm doing a public sort of lot with little payment kiosks, I guess, and then just filling the alley. Now I move on to a fire station. The real Navy Yard has actually the New York City fire boats right there, so I figured a large fire station would probably be fairly appropriate. So I'm going and trying to find colored cars to be like the fire chief's cars and things, and plopping props. I do swap out those vanilla ambulances because I realized I didn't have the right prop, but then I went and downloaded. So now I'm just working on some more warehouse back lots and back walls, going for a lot of fences to prevent people from getting onto the tracks and to kind of delineate properties. A lot of containers, of course, a lot of vans, a lot of parking, oil stains, trucks, a lot of places where you're not supposed to drive, a lot of places that are just like, just right here I figured that maybe like an underground tank of some sort. So it's just a decal and then some pipes with little junction boxes maybe for loading or unloading or something. A lot of these concrete patches and asphalt patches. I use this fence with a bollard. It might seem a little too nice, but I feel it's nautical. Then right here up by the entrance, I figure some green space wouldn't hurt. So I put a little sort of tree garden, I guess. And then of course right next to it, make some filthy dumpster alley. Right here, I figured some nice kind of more modern parking. So there's some bike lots or bike racks and parking lots and green space. Just with little curb props. Then I get back to decaling, sticking patches everywhere, sticking crates and stains and all sorts of different things before starting on what's actually a pretty enormous project here, which would be creating all these crosshatch marks, all shaped correctly, all saying keep clear and everything, just to make sure that nobody by accident stops on these crane tracks, which still sounds weird to say, but everybody's kind of, I guess, needs to stay clear. I do use those box hatches once because I figure why not add some variety. Then I start working on some more parking. Figured this one's a little greener as well. Maybe a slightly newer or renovated industrial facility here running out of these old warehouses and buildings. Again, add more kind of just industrial stuff. Go for some tile just to make things look a little different. A lot of decals. You go and fence off the end of the tracks again. And then start working on the spherical tanks, just adding a little greenery. It's tricky to kind of find spaces where I'd like to put greenery, but it ends up working. So for the rest of this, I'm just placing more and more just kind of industrial props, decals and everything. So I'm actually gonna go until the live portion and enjoy the rest of the time-lapse and the rest of the music. So here we are into the kind of live portion of the video, and we can see that, well, things are shaping up. We have a few empty spots over here. We got this one, which is mostly going to be parking and hopefully some green space, maybe some temporary facilities and temporary structures for this new office building. We've got this tiny little spot that's going to be, God, I don't know. We'll have to see. Maybe some old parking, maybe some construction equipment, maybe just like some containers. I think like something like around here. I think containers would work fine, just kind of as a transition between the nice sort of semi-green space and the construction site and everything around the new medical facility we have over here and the big honkin' polluting factory right across this teeny tiny little street. But in any case, so that'll get filled out here. And then for the section of this live build, I really kind of want to focus on this sort of area. I'm eventually going to do this long, almost harbor sort of thing later. Kind of imagine it's got container cranes, so maybe this teeny little container facility. Might try to sneak in a functional harbor just to help kind of inject some cargo into what's going to be a fairly massive section of city sprawl over here. So having a cargo point would be really handy. Most of the cargo is going to happen on this side of the harbor or the bay. So that would probably be a good idea, but that's definitely kind of a next time task. And I haven't quite figured out what I want to do to detail in here. Obviously it needs it. Right now it's just fenced off and it's definitely going to be kind of a dirty brown field site. So something that's not really cleaned up, not really made nice. Definitely the old section of these Navy yards, maybe former shipbuilding facilities and things. So I just stuck the abandoned factory over here, which is a really weird asset to have had in the stock game, considering it's like orders of magnitude out of scale with a regular actual functional factory. But whatever, I think it looks pretty good here. I like the big smokestack and everything. And it's a nice building to have. Also some warehouses and things that people have parked in and I guess work in. So we'll see if those stay. We'll see what ends up happening there. I might just get rid of the ones with parking and just stick to the plain ones, which I can move around. But right now I need to definitely face a pretty critical problem once we get rid of this. It's that garbage is a disaster, as are dead people. Dead people harder to deal with in kind of keeping it thematic and nice, so I think I'm just going to give the good old ugly temporary solution in just plonking down several little crematoriums around the ugly and temporary solution to the nuclear power plant. But since we're doing an industrial area anyway and smokestacks and things look okay, I think I'll probably do a more permanent solution for garbage. So my thoughts were just to it looked like they didn't have electricity. So my thoughts were just to jump in here and grab one of these roads that's going to end up nice and invisible. We can stick it like that, and then we just kind of cut it across and see if we can end up at some sort of reasonable angle. Of course it didn't actually place, but ooh. Okay, so it really doesn't want to. You know, I'm clicking. That's weird. I've never had that happen before. So we'll just do that sort of wonky and wacky angle and grab some nice, friendly vanilla incinerators. This is just kind of almost random industrial garbage. Garbage. But just random industrial stuff just to add in this sort of spot. I might, you know, that'd be a cool spot for this. So just be careful. There's definitely weirdness when you bring stuff, especially with move it over towards, over towards keys and things. They're really nice to have in game, and I definitely used all the keys and things like crazy, keys and canals all over the place. But they're really finicky and hard to work with trying to put roads near them and basically anything anywhere close to any sort of key, where it's just really makes it hard. So there, it's a nice little shortcut. I'm just going to straighten it out a little bit. I think is probably the smartest move here, because that will let us stick those two incineration plants back, and I'm okay with them looking like that, I guess. Definitely not going to be the main facility. I really wish this didn't have anything on the back here, but whatever, that's fine. And then this kind of triangle. So this is a TV studio. It's from the Futuristic Buildings, I think. Little DLC add-on. It's a neat little asset. I mostly like it for the tower, and just because it came with the pack. This big factory thing I put here just to kind of imagine that it was the studio space. So I do want to decorate the outside of that later, but I might do up some custom props just to really kind of enhance that it's a studio space. So right over here, I'm thinking we'll do trailers, maybe some portable buildings if I can find any, just for makeup and things. A lot of parking for the TV studio, because of course with this game, there are like 12 spots here for all the people, and I thought I'd turn that vehicle off permanently. Oh well, I guess I'll just have to redo that soon. In any case, right here, so I think that'll probably grab a stripe and of course be separated by a fence, which will also mean that I want this chain link gate. I've been to a couple studios here in New York, as well as elsewhere, and they have some crazy tight security around the outsides. So I actually want this barbed wire chain link fence, which feels like it might be overkill, but actually probably isn't. So we're just gonna stick this, I was gonna put it there. So we're just gonna go back a little ways and then go across down to here and then down towards the front over here. We can just leave a little aisle, I guess. And I'm just gonna do regular chain link across the front here, maybe to there. And then I'm going to come from the other side and come in real close, and we can patch up that gap with the gate. You can just align it, and there we go. Nice, so it's a big lot, just a little tiny single access point, but now it's time to grab some semi-trucks. So I want to get these all the same color, and here in New York, they are always, the film semis, are always, always, always blue or white, so I'm just gonna place all of them off to the side until I get a nice array of blue and white ones. I do want a couple blue ones in here. Why are they all coming in rows? How weird. Blue. Nope. 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 There we go. All right, cool. So we're just going to grab trailers now. The trailers are definitely all white. I think one of these is always... these ones are like a little too small. I'm just going to have to deal with this. You can actually use Move It to make sure. Now, they're not quite actually all like this in real life, so I'm going to do some fun stuff. The colors change when you use Move It, don't they? That's frustrating. I don't know why I didn't remember they did that. It's because the random models don't change. So whenever you do it like that, that's why. Okay, so you got that. And now I want the flat trailer that I have somewhere. Flat, woo. Flat, and should be something. I see our train cars. I see a bunch of signs and things. What's it called? I wonder if it didn't load or something. Weird. I know I have it placed a couple spots over here. Yeah, right here. What is this asset called? I have no idea. Oh well, we are gonna copy it from there. And just as an experiment, so, whoa. No, I definitely wanna have snapping off. I don't have snapping off, but where did this trailer go? Okay, so we'll just rotate it around. And what's neat is because these are trailers for film, they are not flatbeds, but instead I want to grab the field office, I think. Nope. Office, but prop only. There it is. Portable office. And I want to stick this. This is like the I'll be in my trailer sort of thing. And I'm just going to grab one and pick it up. And now we can raise it up. So this is, I'm actually really happy this has worked. Here's your film trailers with these little portable offices on the back. And this, I see these all the time. It's always fun to see them because you have no idea what sort of production's going on. I'm actually going to remove this and we're going to select one of these little homebrew trailers here and just stick it out in the open, and I'll put a couple more over here just to show them off. I want my, what is that? Genset. We'll grab a couple generators because those are also around. And now some vans. And awesome, they come in like a pretty close to matching set of colors, which is very cool. So this is kind of the film lot. Nice. So you've got that sort of active parking. You know, it could be cool actually. We'll do some picture cars that they'll have. So this is where we'll get to place a few Lamborghinis and things. Just do a couple of these guys. Not quite sure why they're both red, but it works. A few of these, maybe one of these guys. And now let's see if we have a taxi prop. Yep, of course we do. Because with picture cars, you want to make sure you've got all these different types. Police. Excellent. We got our film production kind of cop cars over here. Fire engine. Of course, you need to make sure you've got on set. Just if you need one as a prop, but just one. And, an ambulance. We'll make sure there's a nice, good-looking one kind of parked back here. So that's pretty cool. That's a nice little pop of color. You get to stick a couple sweet Lamborghinis and everything in there. And I think the rest of this is just going to be maybe a couple buildings if I can find something that I like in there. Because these buildings are not interesting. Do I have any old? I always want to make sure and look through all the old props and things and park assets to see if there's anything that maybe I've missed and just like not made for a long, not built or used for a long time. I know I've got like these little antennae around, but just making sure there's not something cool and new or cool and old that I don't want to be not using for whatever reason. It's actually a neat little building. I wonder if I could stick something like that elsewhere. But in any case, this distribution center stuff's all too big. You could just do like a warehouse. That could work, actually. Do I have the sideways mounting one of these? Yeah, just like that. That does cover up the entrance, though. Maybe I'll stick that over here. That's actually a fantastic fit. Excellent. So that goes there. I still got to fill all this stuff. So I will, I think I'll probably be right back after this, so stay tuned. All right, and I'm back. So I just went and quickly, actually, I did this very fast. I just copied a parking lot that I've already detailed and decorated from over there and stuck it in, and it actually looks really cool. It meant I had to do a little bit of rearranging, so I stuck the vans over here. Maybe it's like craft services or something. But now they have their kind of drive-out point. It's a little tight, but whatever. You can always move them later now. But that's about it for this little parking area. It's lined up against the back here, which feels a little weird up front, but I do want to add some lines in. So let's actually do that now. Let's grab not a tree, but all. And I don't know why I did all. Would have been a lot faster to do that. These are nice and will fit our angles very well. So I'm just going to grab the prop line tool and start getting our angle and sizing right. That looks about right there. And 30 degrees might be a little too much. And also I want to space these out a little farther. That's looking awfully close. Who said these are good truck Parker's anyway, so we can always just assume that. It looks like it's a little too narrow. And I've definitely done this backwards, but there we go. So all the trucks now have little parking lines between them. We can just zero that out and now drag. We can now drag, that's better, a line between them, and we just subtract these until they fit nicely. That looks about right. That looks good. Annoyingly not quite on target, but thank goodness we have my best friend and favorite mod move it. We're just gonna do that and then deselect these fences because we do not want to be moving them. Whoop, but we did not deselect all the right fences. I want to get rid of the fences, and let's get rid of that generator thing too. That's better. Oh, and beautiful. So you can just line that up perfectly in that corner, and we've got our park trucks. Amazing. What else? I think that's fine, actually. I do want to kind of delineate the area for picture vehicles with just some stripe. And yeah, that one is a little bit over the edge, but trust me, when you work with film people, sometimes you have to deal with a little bit over the edge. So that's that for the picture cars, which I think looks good. Let's actually fence them in. Now, I do realize that this would be like some pretty crazy games to play to try to get these things out. And they're already in a fenced parking lot too. Well, you know, let's leave it then. You definitely don't want to have anybody hitting these cars. So here, you know, we'll do a fence like that. But yeah, it'd be pretty crazy if you had to like Tetris some Lamborghinis out of a parking spot before a shoot. So that's pretty good there. Let's grab some decals. And of course I search decals, which is not going to give me anything. And let's grab some skid marks and things. I know there are a few here already, but we can really kind of amp up the detail by kind of sticking it there so they're kind of all flowing towards the exit. We can do the same sort of thing like that, where they're kind of going over and up and around. And then this one's got a cool donut on it, and I was like sticking that in somewhere where it looks like. So there you go. You've got some people who grab those Lamborghinis and do a donut. I'm just gonna do a little bit of cleanup over here. We don't need any of these badly colored trailers. And that's really cool. That's very realistic and nice. So moving along, I think I probably want to grab another little warehouse. My favorite. I love these. They're all by Ivania, or almost all of them are by Ivania. And she is fantastic at these kind of industrial buildings and facilities. And they're all really nice because you can pretty much clip them into each other with reckless abandon. And they'll all work really nicely and still be happy about how you're doing things. Let's just line this up like this. It totally smashes into the wrong spot. Let's try to get the angles to play nice. That'll be good. We definitely have some weird terrain stuff. I was pretty sure this was all flat, but it's weird. So I'm usually not used to working in such a kind of confined scale and space. So I thought everything was flat enough, I suppose, but it's looking like we're seeing some floating cars, we're seeing some floating stuff now. Just pay no attention, and I'll get that fixed real soon. Is that really not? It's nice that we get to control height, but it was also nice when all this stuff just automatically snapped to the ground. They're mostly floating. All right, well, in that case, I'll get to that afterwards. You guys don't need to see me sit here and do that to a million cars. Let's very quickly add a little bit of traffic and parking to the kind of I want to call it an armpit, and they're all black. Everybody drives a black car. It's like they're all working for Uber or something. There you go. So these guys definitely don't need a ton of parking. It's just a big warehouse. Let's actually get a van. We've done vanilla. Now let's get a couple parked vans out here. I think this would be like a mail facility or something. I think they look, yeah, different enough from over there. And what else could we do? Just trying to grab whatever stuff. I'm not really basing this off of anything really specific anymore. So unlike this parking lot, which I've seen and kind of know exactly what's in there, just trying to get a generic sort of style and sense of how these are all working. Stick a couple truck trailers in there. And I actually honestly think that that's pretty good. I do want to do like maybe a container yard over here. So we can grab, I don't want to do a stack, but I do want to grab a couple of on the ground 40 footers. Excellent. So that looks really nice. Let's just get some fencing. I think probably, I really like this corrugated metal fence by Beard Monkey. I see it a lot in the areas that I'm pretending this all is. So yeah, there's definitely a lot of realism in this. It's a little backwards, but I honestly don't care. I kind of like the texture of the supporting stuff as much or more. So that's pretty good for over here, actually. I want to keep this alley clear so I can put some crates. What are these called? Pallet crate set. Let's just pallet. Pallet, just the one. What is this? Pallet full. Oh, it's just like a full pallet. Excellent. I am going to use the drum, the barrels, and drums, I think mostly, but I will fill in here. Those ones are slightly. I really just want two wide of these. Yeah. Just like that. And let's grab some empty pallets as well. And some barrels. Ooh, two R's in the word barrel. Just decorate some of these. And now a forklift. And I think this little area as well now just needs some decals, and it can be finished off as well. This edge is definitely going to get cleaned up once I do the sort of brownfield site, which will probably be next episode. Let's grab some stain decals, which I really like. They just add some used feeling to the rest of the sort of old concrete and everything. So definitely in here, it's actually a drain as well that I try to reserve for kind of grimier areas, and this looks like a good one. I'll put one there, and it's just slightly too wide. It's got this very sharp edge, so I want to try to avoid that. Patch. So one other thing that you can do is just grab some of these patch decals. We can do this. We can do, that's too wide, but we can go width, and that's still too wide. There we go. And you can just do a little asphalt patch like that, and then grab them, copy them, and really kind of patch up the asphalt there. Let's continue it down. It's kind of like they did a pipe or something. That just adds some little detail. You can do some small irregular ones too, like they're filling cracks or something. In fact, whoops, we can grab some cracks and really kind of, I like this. This concrete decal or concrete texture is actually a modified one from Strict Toaster's Sinew project. And it's really nice because it's definitely a blank slate to kind of work through and work with. Let's add some. Maybe they didn't do such a great job patching up those cracks. But since it's so blank, it definitely needs a lot of decal work and a lot of stuff to kind of give it enough variation, because when you see an area that's just big and blank, it doesn't really have tremendously detailed kind of tiling or any sort of actual texture on it already. So that I actually think looks really nice, and hopefully that will get a reasonable amount of traffic from our garbage trucks. Yep, there they all go. And I think that's actually going to be it for this episode. I just want to thank you guys so much for watching. This has been a lot of fun to make. It's a lot of detail stuff, and I'm really excited to kind of continue. This is a big project, actually. It's felt a little big to start with, and now it's feeling like it was really big, especially when it's like a reasonably sized block. And when I look at kind of the size of some of these piers and things, it's really thrown my sense of scale off. So I'm placing big stuff and expecting it to be like a lot larger, like these big factories. I'm like, these are huge. So I actually look back at this, it's like almost kind of a tile size. Each side is definitely not full, but this is a huge project. And thank you for watching this video if you've made it all the way through. And I'm really excited to kind of continue with more projects, because while this, I guess, was big, I really want to fill like most of this area with city, and I'm hoping the game will remain stable enough for that. I'm hoping that that you guys will like want to see that. I've really kind of fingers crossed, but yeah, it's gonna be a lot of fun. This area is really, really close by to me in real life. I took a lot of inspiration from walking past it, from walking around, and kind of living. Not really in, like right here, but in real life, I live kind of within this circle of it. So I see a lot of the traffic stuff, and I see a lot of it. I see the it actually has two smokestacks, and I see them every day coming back and forth from school, which is a lot of fun. So it's really nice to build something so close, and definitely kind of this whole city is going to be designed off of what I see on a daily basis living here in New York. I've got a whole bunch of special subway trains, special like assets, lots of stuff that I want to be making for this series, just so you can kind of really get the same sort of sense of New York City feel, and kind of everything's made for it and made right, and not just generic assets plonked down. So I'm hoping this will have a lot of style and a lot of cool builds and substance, and maybe even some like really careful one-to-one recreations of areas in real life. I've been wanting to do my building. I've been wanting to do where I go to school, etc. Just as ploppable buildings or growables even. So I'm really excited to kind of get the ball rolling on this. So please, if you'd like to see more of this, definitely subscribe. There's a lot of cool stuff to come. We've got airports. We've got huge harbors based on some spots in New Jersey. We've got all sorts of cool, specially custom-made assets from trains to new airplanes to hopefully I'm trying to break into buildings with this. Lots of decals, lots of really nice stuff. Obviously, a bunch of billboards and signs. I hopefully want to have like proper exit signs for every single piece of the highway, which would be like crazy to have to import and sort through, but it could be worth it. Could be a lot of fun just to have. Maybe I'll do like a special first person video and just have it just for those. But in any case, thank you very much for watching. Subscribe if you are interested in seeing more, and I will see you next time.